Yesterday, I put out a video talking about why I think that everyone should have their own personal website. Now, at the end of that video, I preempted a certain kind of comment that I expected to get on that video, and I indeed got lots of this comment, and I want to talk about how much it upsets me. Now, there are very few things that actually upset me, very few things that actually rile me up, but I loathe blackpilling. I loathe, if you don't know what blackpilling is, if you're a normal friend, that just means extreme pessimism. I loathe pessimism. I loathe defeatism. Let me explain to you why. Now, let me say, in this video, I recommended people should start their own websites for many reasons, one of them being that it makes you more independent of using social media sites. You don't have to think about, oh, am I gonna get banned for saying this? Are there gonna be some kind of consequences for this? Having your own internet property makes things easier for you. You have more leeway. You have become more mentally free. Now, what people said, not the majority of people, but a small minority that I, again, expected, said about this is, hey man, you can't start your own website, dude, because, man, they can't ban you from Facebook, but they're just gonna, like, get rid of your domain name, or like they're gonna contact your host and you're just gonna get shut down, man. It's no use. There's no use in like being more independent. They're just gonna come for you, man. And this is a mentality that is all over the place nowadays. Another thing that I'm interested in, you know, if you guys know, if you've been watching the channel, I'm looking at different plots of land to buy so I can build my own house, stuff like that. And, you know, preferably somewhere a little off-grid or unregulated. But people in that community, the survivalist community, whatever you want to call them, I don't know, they will say stupid things like, hey man, it doesn't matter if you get your own place, dude, because, like, you'll still have to pay, like, property taxes, man. And that's, like, just, like, renting it from the government. You can't do everything you really want. It's not even your property, man. Like, just because you think you own it, but it doesn't matter. Or let's say someone wants to start an internet business. Let's say they don't like their real job because they don't have intellectual freedom. You might say, oh, I'll start an internet business. I'm already starting things up. I'm getting lots of money. These people will come to you and say, hey, man, you can't do that. You can't do that, man, because, like, dude, PayPal is just gonna shut you down, man. They're gonna shut you down. It's no use. Like, it's totally worthless, man. Just give it up. People like this will say this all the time. Now, is this, I mean, why are people acting like this? Is it just that everyone on the internet is 14 years old and is listening to Bill Hicks? No, it's not because of that. It's a particular psychological mindset that people are in. Let's explain it. Let's explain why people say this stuff. Now, it is not because they sat down and thought reasonably about the consequences of political dissidents or any of this kind of stuff, because although there have been many people who have been banned from PayPal, or who have, you know, the EPA finds some reason to, you know, fine them $1 million on their land or something like that. There are high profile stories of this happening. It doesn't just magically happen to everyone. Andrew Anglin lost his domain a lot of times, but Andrew Anglin is one guy, and it's not something that's going to happen just to you if you try and make yourself more independent. It's not these people are not putting forth a reasonable viewpoint. It is, however, when you think of blackpilling, when you think of pessimism as a psychological defense mechanism, everything becomes very clear. Because you might think that pessimism is this deep, it's a really rigorous stance because, I mean, I just feel bad about it, man. It's like, it's really, I don't know, risque to believe something like that. No, it's the easiest thing in the universe. Because what pessimism is a way for you to think, basically a way for you to justify doing nothing. Because if you can't affect the world, then you have no reason to affect the world. Then the biggest brain thing that you can possibly do is sit at home, watch Rick and Morty, watch porn, waste your life away, and accomplish nothing. That's the end result. And that's what these people want, to just be able to go on 8chan and post anime girls all day. That is what it, and it's not just rationalizing their world, the way that they behave. It also makes it seem like the smartest thing in the world to do and accomplish nothing. Now, for example, you know, these people will go and, you know, go to someone like me, or go to anyone who has their own property, who tries to be independent, who does anything, and they'll come to you and they'll say stuff like, hey man, it's really me, I'm really the smart one, because, like, I'm not wasting my time with that stuff, because it's all useless, man. They're just gonna come for you. Hey man, it's all over, just give up. That is their mentality, and it is a defense mechanism that makes being basically a loser be the smartest thing ever. Now, I'm not saying, mind you, I'm not saying that you need to be optimistic in everything. I'm not an optimist. I'm simply saying that this viewpoint is unreasonable. There are some domains that I think are unreasonable. For example, I think it's pretty... universities, for example, are beyond repair. We're not going to be able to repair them. They're just over. You can think of me as being pessimistic with respect to universities. Now, that's not because I just want to wallow in despair and I think there's nothing that can be done about the world. No, it's just because I think in that case, it's not something that you can do. There are other alternatives for reform, but there are some domains that you can make an assessment and say it's a difficult thing to do. But what I'm saying is the people who say this stuff about there's no reason for you to care about, like, using a, you know, free software or something, man, because, you know, there are cameras in public, they're spying on you, dude. It's no use. These people who say this kind of stuff, they're just rationalizing doing nothing. They're just rationalizing not accomplishing anything and just being as miserable as possible. They're trying to make the absolute bottom of the totem pole of sitting there being a passive observer, just sort of making snide remarks at people. They're trying to make that seem like the smartest thing in the world, and it isn't. Pessimists are literally losers. It is not that, I'm not saying you have to be optimistic about everything, but there are some people who just, they just have to be doomers. Everything's just screwed, man, it's all over. And these people do not believe it because they sat down and rationally decided upon it. They believe it because they are trying to rationalize being losers. Now, I'm not just calling you a loser if you say this kind of stuff, but I'm just saying, if your response to any kind of, someone who says that they want to become more independent or they want to be proactive, if your response is to try and shoot that down, just check yourself, because when it comes down to it, that's usually a sign. If your response is to do that every single time, if that is your response, there's probably something, you should probably just keep it inside, just because that mentality is a kind of disease. And if you are showing the symptoms of that disease, just calm down, be reasonable, and try and put your life on the right tracks, I guess. Anyway, so that's all I wanted to say in this video. But just stop being a doomer. I hate this mentality. Anyway, I've already said it, everything. I'll see you guys next time.